Hi, I'm going to do a very quick recap of how to do the activities in this session with symbology in MATLAB 2014. I'm using 2014B, but as far as I'm aware, it looks exactly the same as 2014A, but there have been some changes compared to the version of MATLAB that was referenced in the textbook, that's 2012A. So the first task that you're asked to do is simulate the model with all the default parameters but a longer task stop time. So we see here the stop time by default is 10 seconds. If I expand that, we see we've got options to either use the simulation settings, so that's this window, or set a stop time specific to this task. So as we're going to be running a few simulations, I'm just going to change it in simulation settings. So I've got the stop time, so instead of stopping at 10 units of time, I'm going to stop at 600. And if you remember, when we're loading the biomodels, the unit of time used in the model is minutes. So even though MATLAB is writing second there, we're actually working in minutes because that's what was loaded in the model. So you see now I've changed that, it's updated this task stop time here. So the other change is that now in our task thing, in our task window, we have down this end the, if you like, the workflow. So we start with description, so we could add a description if we like. We've got our model, the stop time, states to log, we can ignore that for now, variance to apply, doses to apply, these aren't things we need to worry about, but plots to generate. So at the end of the exercise we want a plot, so you can see here there's a plot, that's just going to plot every species in the reaction, but if we want a plot we can edit, we need to generate one. So I'm going to click generate plot after run. I'm going to extend this so I can actually see what's going on. And to begin with, we're just going to plot everything. So we see that says all, and that's, if I double click, we can see it's everything is selected. Okay. It's actually changed it to select them, but there's no difference there. So now if I click run, what we see is very quickly it simulated the system. Here is the plot, the sort of live result plot, and in a moment it's generating the plot that we set up there. And here's the plot that we can compare with in our notes. Let me go to the textbook notes and find the right one. Here's the plot that we're comparing it to. And although the legend, the colours used for all the different species is different, you can see that we seem to have the same lines. Let me go back, and what the exercise asks you to do is look at the individual components of this graph, the individual lines, and the best way to do this is to go into the plot tools mode, and that gives us tools where we can just select different lines, turn lines on and off. So I'll just turn the top ATP line on. And suppose we, and what we can see is as we change the components shown, the graph actually rescales to include all the details. And if we want to eliminate this first section, because that's a transient section where the system is stabilizing, reaching this sort of equilibrium oscillation that it gets to, if we click on the x-axis, we get this control here, and we can just change that to start it from 100, and that means that we get a better view of those oscillations. And you can see I can probably just zoom in on a smaller region if I want to get a good look at what the shape of those oscillations are. So I'm going to just look at the last 50 minutes of the plot, and here you go, I've got a look of the oscillations. And now, to answer that question, I can just work through these different components, and you see the glucose doesn't look like it's reached an equilibrium yet, it's still increasing, but there is an oscillation behavior. If I don't have this time set up in, what you see is those oscillations are invisible because they're very small perturbations, they're very small compared to this overall trend right from the start of the time series. So using this control, you can answer that activity about the oscillations of the various components. And what's interesting to do, I think, is to try and follow through this backbone of the reaction. So we see glucose going to pyruvate. I've sort of put together a backbone in my model as it gets converted, and see how the sort of components change as we go along there. So that's part one. If I want to go back to my task, I click on project and I can see I've got my simulations open there, so I've actually run it twice. And the next thing we're asked to do is just plot a few of these components. So it asks us to plot ATP and NADH. So I'm going to turn everything else off. I selected clear all, then put those two back on. And again, I'm going to click run. And although they're all plotted on this, on the main graph, when the results come up, we only have ATP and NADH plotted. And what we're asked to do is just alter the time on that from 100 on the x-axis to 300. Okay, and so that's the plot we're asked to produce to begin with, and the activity that follows just asks you to do the same thing again, but with different components and a slightly different time. So the next task for us in this exercise is to it's to generate which to run a scan. So we're going to run a scan with different values for the flow rate. So if we look down in our, when we're running a scan task, we've got an extra couple of boxes in the workflow, values to scan defined with and values to scan. And if you read the textbook, it actually refers to this value to scan table, and it says to double click component lane and enter flow. So as I click F, it brings up all the parameters that are included in that model. So the concentration of F6P and FBP, and also this parameter flow, which controls the flow rate through the vessel. So the rate at which substrate is in the stock solution is dripped in, and equally some of the solution is removed, so we get a constant volume. So we're going to alter the flow, and we're going to change, you see as I've put that in, it's actually added some values to scan in for me, but we don't want whatever it's added, so we're going to put in the same values that we used in the paper. So I'm just going to scan down to where this was. Here we go, I'd already selected it. Here's the four values of flow used in the paper. So I'll copy those, paste them in, and there we have the values of scan. Now again, we need to generate plots. Generate plots, and By default, it generates two sets of plots. We don't need those. We don't need two plots. I'm going to delete the ones it's added by default. Select a new plot. Time plot. All we want is ATP, so clear all and select ATP. And subplot has disappeared, but the trellis plot actually looks very similar to the subplot. So it gives us the four plots arranged in the four corners of our figure. And I think we're ready to go. So when I click run, it's going to run the four simulations, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then it's going to generate that plot, so that should pop up in a minute. Ah, I didn't click generate plot after run. So let's go plot data. So because I'd forgotten to click this plot, generate plots after run, I had to go here and generate them manually with plot data. But that's no worry. So here we are with our plot, and what you can see is we have something that closely mirrors the plot that was produced here. Okay, so now we're just going to have a quick look at how to do the assignment task. So the easiest way to do this is to run a scan again, even though we've only got one change to the flow rate. By running a scan we can change that easily. So let's just change the flow, double click flow, change the value. So we look in the paper, the flow rate is 8.2 times 10 to the minus 3. 8.2e-3 is how we can write it in MATLAB. And this time we need to change the stop time, and we look at the paper, it's actually plotted over 45 hours, but this is after it's reached its sort of equilibrium setting. There's no sort of initial transient period plotted, so we need to plot for a little bit longer than 45 hours and then remove that. So I'm going to plot for 50 hours. So to plot for 50 hours, I'm going to say 50 times 60, 50 hours, 50 times 60 minutes. If I do that on a calculator, I need 3,000 minutes. Okay, now I need to generate my plot. And again, stretch this out so I can see what I'm doing. And all I want is the NADH, so that's what they plotted in their result. Show live plots, because we're doing it for a very long time, I'll turn that off. Now I can run. Ah, I forgot to click generate plots after run, so let's just plot data manually. And you can see there's our plot. And to get the same as figure 10, what I'm going to need to do is knock off the first 5 hours, so that is 300 minutes. And there we have it. If I compare this to their graph, they plotted from 3.6 to 4.2, so I'll change that as well. And there we have my result. And to save it, file, save as. fig10. And to include it in my Word file, I'll save it as a PNG file in my documents. Save. Okay, well, I hope that's helped you out, especially if you've got MATLAB 2014. If you've got any questions, please ask them in the forum. And best of luck with the rest of the course.